Corey, welcome back to my channel. Welcome to my channel if you're new here. So for today's video, I am talking all about my Falmouth uni audition. Spoiler, I have picked Falmouth and I am actually going in September. So I'm just going to cut to the chase. I auditioned for theatre and performance and then also acting, both BA Hon. So I auditioned for two courses, but I did one audition for both. I got an unconditional for both, which I can't actually believe. So now I'm going to tell you all about the audition process. We did a little like building tour of the building for drama. I'd done that before on the open day, so that was fine. The acting and theatre group, which was me, went into one room. There was musical theatre, there was music, and then there was like technical directors and stuff. So there was only six of us in our class, and we were met with two lecturers, a lady and a man. We all sat in a circle. They just introduced the courses, and I think I was the only one there auditioning for both. The other five people were all there for acting. I don't think they were there for theatre and performance. Feta got us to stand up in a group for a warm-up, and we had to do this like kind of song rhythm kind of thing. So we all say this together: hey, my name is Joe, I work at a button factory, I have a wife, three kids, and one day my boss said to me, he said, Joe, are you busy? I said, no. He said, push that button with your right hand. Hey,
my name is Joe, I work at a button factory, I have a wife and three kids, and one day my boss said to me, he said, Joe, are you busy? He said,
push that button with your left hand. And you keep going, you add left and right leg, you do bum, you do nose, and then you do tongue. And then at the end you'll go, hey. So funny, but it warmed us all up. Then we walk around the space, and we had to say hi to people, make eye contact with people, and then we had to compliment each other as we walked by. And then we had to walk around the space shouting the compliments that we just received. And then we had to walk around the space and first lead with your forehead. And then they said, okay, now think in your head what kind of mood you would have if you're leading with your forehead and you're walking around like that. So I picked lost. You're walking around with your mood, put a name to that person. Now put a house to that person. You're literally just walking around and everyone's dead silent, just thinking of the scenarios in their head. So I had Jennifer, she lived in a flat, she lived alone, she had just been broken up with, she goes to school, she, like, uni, she just does work and studies and then goes home and doesn't talk to anybody. Basically, you're just walking around like that, and you're just thinking of this whole story, but you're not acting it at all. And then, at the end of the whole story you've got in your head, you have to think of what their voice would be like, and then you have to walk around and talk as them, but like no one's listening, and really no one was listening to each other because we're all doing our own thing. So I was making her quite stuttery, like really shy and stuff, and there was other people walking around, they were saying different things, but I didn't hear what they were doing because everyone's in their own world. And we did the same, but we led with our chest, and then I had the mood of overconfident, like quite like full of themselves. Really good to get into the mindset of a character and really embody them. I really liked that technique. We sat down and we discussed how that was good for acting. Then we all sat in like a long line, and one by one we all went up to do our monologue, and I went up and I performed it. And then before moving on to the next person, this is the difference between Falmouth and Bath, they actually redirected it and got me to do it differently. So I sit angled on a chair talking to an imaginary person who's also angled on a chair. So there's two chairs. They actually put the chair in front of me with their back to the audience, and they actually put one of the boys in the chair, and then they told me to stand up and be angry. So I had to say the whole monologue again, but looking him in the eyes like angry, and I literally was shouting at him, I was doing snarly faces. I felt it was quite good. We went through our second ones and we literally just performed them. So I did the second one from Girls Like That, and I played the monologue of the girl in flowers in her hair, and we sat in a circle and we asked questions. And when we'd hear back by them, they said within 5 working days and stuff like that. And then that was it. So I was like thinking, where's the interview? Because basically for this course, I watched a lot of webinars that Falmouth hold. They did an hour long chat session. You could ask questions and stuff. First one was all about accommodation and interviews. Second one was all about like interviews, but like portfolios and stuff. And they mentioned how you could bring a laptop and show like digital portfolio work and stuff like that, as well as portfolio. And then they showed all the questions you might get asked at interviews and what you could ask. So when I found that there was no interview, I was like, what? So I went up to the lady and I was like, hi, when's the interview? She went, oh, we decided to do our class discussion, that there's no need for interviews. I'm like, I was shocked. I was like, oh my gosh, I've been carrying around a laptop. This is a lot like Bath. Like, Bath didn't want to see my portfolio or my laptop. So it's like, oh, I've been watching webinars and they were saying about interviews, and well, I prepared a portfolio for this, would you like to see it? Just had a flick through and chatted to me a little bit about it, and I didn't end up showing my laptop because I thought that's too much to now suddenly get it out. And then we left, so it was a really short, it was from 1:30 until 4:30, so 3 hours long. I personally felt that I couldn't get an unconditional from that because I just felt that they couldn't see what my acting's like because they saw my monologue, that is a big part of the acting, and then the warm-up exercises and some of the activities we had to do. But the one where we had to walk around and just envision our character in our head, we weren't actually acting, and that was like a good 40 minutes of an exercise. So I just felt like that was a whole chunk where, yes, I was really feeling the character, it was really helping me skill-wise, but in this interview process, they aren't seeing how I'm actually acting. But in the interview, I would be able to show them my passion for acting more because I'd be able to talk about what I've worked on, past work and stuff, but I wasn't able to do that. Anyway, 2 days later, so it wasn't the next evening, it was the evening after, I actually got an email, and it was from UCAS saying that there had been an update to my application for Falmouth. I ran downstairs so that my parents could see as well, and I went and opened it and I was shaking, and first thing I saw straight away the moment I logged in was Theatre and Performance had given me an unconditional, and I cried and I was overwhelmed. I couldn't believe it. And then amidst a cry, I thought, oh, I should go have a look to see if acting have got back to me, they may not have. And then I saw that they gave me an unconditional tea and I was like dumbfounded. I couldn't take it. I instantly made up my mind that that is where I want to be. Falmouth is my top, just because I've literally, the moment I saw Falmouth, like that, I feel like I belong there. The next day I went and put in my firm choice, which was acting, because we went and me and my parents did a lot more research, even though I was pretty sure the difference in theatre and performance, and I definitely came to the conclusion I wanted acting. Didn't have to put an insurance choice because all of my options are unconditional. I got an acceptance email into Falmouth, and the very next day I had to submit my ID photo for my ID badge and my lanyard, which means I'm officially in. So I sent in my headshots because I thought that was quite professional, and then also they sent me like a questionnaire if I need any like educational assistance and stuff, which I don't think I need. I've also looked since then into accommodation. I've made an account on their application website where you apply for application, but apparently on the website it says you can't actually open that account until the 3rd of February, but I opened it, so I don't know, but I've done it. You can't apply for accommodation until April. So I've got my 5 top choices, and once it releases in April, I'm gonna put them down straight away. It's just such an exciting chapter. Like, I can't believe I'm going to Falmouth. Like, that is my dream uni, it is, and I can't wait to start studying there. I'm gonna be watching this at the end of the year in uni. And I cannot wait to do moving vlogs and Freshers Week vlogs and showing you my room. The content is gonna change quite dramatically on my channel. The channel's growing with me, and now I'm gonna start a new chapter in my life. I also received in the post 2 letters from Falmouth, both saying congratulations. I hope you guys did enjoy this video. If you did, please give it a massive thumbs up and subscribe down below if you have not subscribed already, and turn on post notifications so you never miss an upload. All my social media links are in the description box below. You can go check them out and follow me on any of those. I love you guys so very much, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!